Welcome to the presentation about clickbait spoiling via question answering and passage retrieval at ACL 2022. This is joint work by Matthias Hagen, Mike Fröbe, Otto York and Martin Potthast. The first thing that might come to your mind when you hear spoiling might be the practice to put spoiler warnings before a description that reveals some plot elements of a movie. Here you see maybe one of the best known spoilers in which we reveal that Darth Vader is the father of Luke Skywalker. Such spoilers might ruin the experience of a movie. We do not want to create such movie spoilers because they might reduce the experience of users. Instead, we want to create good spoilers that save users a click. So we want to spoil clickbait posts. Clickbait posts create a curiosity gap to generate clicks. Here we see a clickbait tweet asking how to keep workout clothes from stinking. The answer given in the linked document is rather trivial. We should simply wash the workout clothes. This answer could have been easily integrated into the tweet, but then users would not click on the link to close their curiosity gap. This second tweet asks what the "someone is typing" bubble in messaging apps actually means. And again, the answer is rather trivial. Someone is typing. In this work, we propose the novel task of clickbait spoiling. Generate a short text that satisfies the curiosity induced by a clickbait post. To tackle this novel task, we create the Webis Clickbait Spoiling Corpus 2022. Our goal was to produce 5000 spoilable clickbait posts with high quality annotations. Therefore, we used 5 social media accounts that manually spoil clickbait and the Webis Clickbait 70 dataset to collect clickbait tweets and the linked pages. Overall, we put 560 hours of in-house annotations into the creation of the dataset. We manually filtered unspoilable or false positive clickbait posts and also did a manual main content extraction to accurately remove all kinds of noise from the documents. Additionally, we annotated the exact position of the clickbait spoiler in the linked document, as can be seen in this example. During the construction of the dataset, we found that there are 3 different types of spoilers: phrase spoilers, passage spoilers, and multi-spoilers. Phrase spoilers consists of 5 or less consecutive words, like "thin piece of rock," and often phrase spoilers are entities or nouns. Passage spoilers, on the other hand, consist of 5 or more consecutive words, like the sentence "just leave the dongle attached to the headphones" from the previous example. Such passage spoilers are often descriptions. The first and last spoiler type are multi-spoilers that consist of lists or enumerations that close multiple curiosity gaps. Our hypothesis was that question answering approaches can spoil phrase spoilers and passage retrieval approaches can spoil passage spoilers. Since there is no existing solution for multi-spoilers, we leave those spoilers for future work. Here we see an overview of the final Webis Clickbait Spoiling Corpus consisting of 5000 clickbait posts together with the required spoiler type and the linked document with the exact position of the spoiler. Our dataset has roughly the same number of phrase and passage spoilers and comes with predefined training and validation splits to ensure reproducibility of our experiments. With this dataset, we support two subtasks to cover the whole spoiling pipeline. The first subtask is the spoiler type classification, where one should classify the type of spoiler required for some clickbait post. The second subtask is then to generate the spoiler that can be shown to users. Here, our initial hypothesis was that question answering is suitable for phrase spoilers and passage retrieval models for passage spoilers. For spoiler type classification, we experiment with two classes of approaches. First, feature-based models, and second, transformer models. We experiment with three classical models, naive Bayes, logistic regression, and support vector machines. For those models, we used TF and TF-IDF features of uni and bigrams from the clickbait posts and the linked web pages as input for the model and did some feature selection with G-square. We experimented with three transformer models, BERT, DBERTA, and TrueBERTA, which use the text of the post concatenated to the main content of the linked page as input for the classification. Here we see the results for the classification of phrase versus passage spoilers, and we see that logistic regression is the best feature-based approach with an accuracy of 70%. All transformer models have a higher accuracy, and TrueBERTA achieves the highest accuracy of 80% for spoiler type classification. Now that we can determine the spoiler type, we can continue with the next step in our pipeline, the spoiler generation. Here we see the effectiveness of three question answering and three passage retrieval models in spoiling phrase and passage clickbait posts. All question answering models were first fine-tuned on the squad dataset and then on our corpus. We did a pilot study with 20 models, and here we show only the most interesting results. We report the BERT score for each model with respect to the ground truth spoiler and the precision at 1, whether the spoiler is in the passage retrieved at the top position by a passage retrieval model. For question answering approaches, precision at 1 reports whether the model extracted the answer from the correct passage, which basically would mean to use a question answering model to retrieve a single passage. Overall, we see that question answering models substantially outperform all passage retrieval models. DBERTA has the highest effectiveness for phrase spoilers with a BERT score of 77% and also for passage spoilers with a BERT score of 51%. Interestingly, our initial hypothesis that passage retrieval approaches are well suited for passage spoilers turned out to be wrong, as question answering models treated as passage retrieval models are more effective in this case. For example, DBERTA achieves a precision at 1 of 54%, while MonoT5 gets only a precision at 1 of 29%. Finally, we also evaluate the end-to-end effectiveness by comparing two-step pipelines with single-step approaches. The two-step pipeline runs first the spoiler type classification, and in the second step it uses the predicted spoiler type to run a dedicated spoiler generation model. On the other hand, the single-step approach simply skips the spoiler type classification and uses the same spoiler model on all posts. For all three different architectures, DBERTA achieves the highest BERT score. Using the two-step approach with our TrueBERTA classifier for spoiler type classification and DBERTA for the spoiler generation achieves a BERT score of 59. Skipping the type classification in the single step approach improves the BERT score to 60%. Still, the two-stage pipeline has some remaining potential because DBERTA with Oracle spoiler types achieves a substantial higher BERT score of 64. The main takeaways from our work are that we proposed clickbait spoiling as a new task. This clickbait spoiling task aims at presenting users a short text that satisfies the curiosity induced by a clickbait post. To run initial experiments on this task, we created the first large resource for clickbait spoiling, the WBIS Clickbait Spoiling Corpus 2022. Our experiments showed that there are still improvements possible in clickbait spoiling by improving the spoiler type classification. We make all our code and all our data publicly available at GitHub and also Zenodo. And as future work, we want to explore also other approaches to clickbait spoiling, as our initial experiments showed that there is still room for improvement. It might also be interesting to paraphrase a clickbait post so that the post directly contains its own spoiler as a future task. And also, we did not address multi-part spoilers so far, but we think that maybe summarization approaches might be adapted to spoil multi-part clickbait posts. So we also leave this as future work. I would like to thank you for your attention.